George counts 1889 to 1974, building a new order. Key points: George counts wanted teachers to lead society instead of following society. Number two, teachers should be concerned with school matters, but should also be concerned with controversial matters of economics, politics, and morality. Number three, if school teachers were to act as statespersons, then the solving of major issues would result in a new social order. Number four, he challenged the teacher to use school as means of critiquing and transforming the social order, which is known now as the pamphlet "Dare the School Build a New Social Order," 1932. Counts authorized scores of scholarly works that advanced the social study of education and emphasized teaching as a moral and political enterprise. His work on schooling and society continued to have relevance to contemporary dilemmas in education. Sociology and education. Counts was interested in the study of social conditions and problems and their relationship to education. Heavily influenced by Albion, Small, and other Chicago sociologists, Counts saw in sociology the opportunity to examine and reshape schools by considering the impact of social forces and varied political and social interests on educational practice. For example, in the selective character of American secondary education in the year 1922, Counts demonstrated a close relationship between students' perseverance in school and their parents' occupation. In the social composition of boards of education, a study in the social culture of public education, 1972, and School and Society in Chicago, 1928, which is another example, he asserted that dominant social classes control American boards of education and school practices respectively, because the schools were run by the capitalists, who wielded school and economics power. Counts argued school practice tended towards the status quo, including the preservation of an unjust distribution of wealth and power. John Dewey and Counts believe in the enormous potential of education to improve society and that schools should reflect life rather than be isolated from it. But unlike Dewey's public and its problems, much of Counts' writing suggests a plan of action in the use of schools to fashion a new social order. Social reform. Counts was accordingly critical of the child-centered progressives or their failure to articulate any conception of a good society. He chided their preoccupation with individual growth at the expense of democratic solidarity and social justice. In his speech, the Progressive Education Association, PEA, Dare Progressive Education Be Progressive, which later became the pamphlet Dare the School Build a New Social Order. Another example, he argued that progressive education had elaborated no theory of social welfare and that it must emancipate itself from the influence of class. Political activism. Counts was also a political activist. He was chairman of the American Labor Party in the year 1942 to 1944, a founder of the Liberal Party and a candidate for New York City Council, Lieutenant Governor, and the U.S. Senate. He was president of the American Federation of Teachers, AFT, and a member of Commission on the Social Studies of American Historical Association. He was the first editor of the progressive journal Social Frontier, which at its peak boasted a circulation of 6,000 and advocated enlisting teachers in the reconstruction of society. What does he want? For him, schools could be the lever of radical social change. Highly critical of economic and social norms of selfishness, individualism, and inattention to human suffering, Counts wanted educators to engage in a positive task of creating a new tradition in American life. He wanted teachers to go beyond abstract philosophical conceptions of democracy and teach explicitly about power and injustice. He wanted teachers and students to count among their primary goals the building of a better social order. In conclusion, George Counts liked the progressive type of education. Teachers should not only be concerned with school matters, but should also be concerned with controversial matters of economics, politics, and morality. George Counts believed the school was an agency involved in society's politics, economics, art, religion, and ethics. The school, in order to be socially reconstructive, he had to help solve problems. That is all. Thank you.